Good evening. 13th of January, it's Awareness Day, and quite honestly, it was one of the very productive days in the recent past. I was very happy that I got a lot of work done today. And in fact, like when I say a lot of work, I did like quite a lot of follow-ups, quite a lot of assignments, quite a lot of updates. I mean, maybe call it my procrastination or whatever. I say like, I'll do it later kind of thing. But today, when I got up in the morning, I had some work on sending some stuff to my sister. So I knew that I'll be away almost 11 o'clock. But I just sat down and I wrote a list of things that I need to do after all my morning calls are done. And as soon as I was back from the so-called courier work and finished my morning meetings, I just started doing these things, and in the flow, I just kept on going, and I didn't have any distractions or whatever. And for whatever reason, I had got up in the morning and I thought that I will do 24-hour fasting. So my last meal was at 10 o'clock last night. So I just decided I will do a 24-hour fasting, and I knew that I don't have to go down to have my lunch or coffee or nothing. So I just kept on doing stuff which I'd written down. I think I covered almost 90% of them. Maybe it's just one of them which I didn't do, which I can probably do it today, sorry, rather tomorrow or on Friday. Not really of a high priority one, but others which I've actually ticked off are pretty good ones. So I'm really happy about the way the work progressed today. And I really hope and pray things are like this every day. I mean, if I'm really able to sit down for like say 15 minutes or half an hour, think about all the work that needs to be done during the day. And when I say during the day, I typically want to concentrate on office related stuff. In fact, like morning when I wrote the list, I had written about some of the first personal stuff I had to do. I had to call up quite a few people and follow up certain things. I have not done those, which is I think fine, because it's a weekday and full day I'm like tied up with work. So I didn't get distracted or got any thought about doing the other list, which I can probably do tomorrow. It's no harm, like those things can wait. But again, starting the day with probably a list of things to do is something which I think I need to start practicing and doing more often. And another good thing about today was I attended one training or session or whatever about all this performance assessment thing that we are going to do over the next 2 weeks for the last year. And I think I referred to it about yesterday as well, about me completing it for another small team or a set of reportees in my team. In fact, like today's session was by I think about two folks, two very senior manager folks from India team, and they quite literally answered a lot of things that was there in my mind, how to approach, how to do, how not to do, more so specifically how to talk when you're communicating it to the team, how to talk. In fact, like they ran a poll in the very beginning of the session, and they realized that 50%, close to 50% of the attendees today were new managers. That included me as well. So in that way, it was a good pointer and guidance about what really we need to do, how really we need. I mean, considering the fact that this time it is a virtual feedback session, unlike whatever we used to have in the past. And for me, this time being the very first time, I'm doing a feedback session, and this has to be done on a WebEx meeting. So in fact, they told like how you need to present yourself, how you need to communicate, what to avoid, what not to avoid. Anyway, I think it was very good educative stuff. Another thing that came in that training was about this aspect about 360 degree feedback. This is exactly the point that I think I mentioned yesterday, where one of my senior team member, he told about there should be an option wherein the resources themselves come back and tell what is it we are doing good, what is it we are doing wrong, where are the places of improvement and stuff like that, which they brought it up. And I think, yeah, again, this is more of like a topic which is getting discussed at an organizational level. So I'm pretty happy that this is not just limited to my thought process or my team. So it can definitely be adopted across this world. And talking about the areas of improvement, one another topic that got highlighted today was about negative feedback. See, all this performance appraisal discussion, there is always this aspect like, at least there will be like one or two resources. I'm not telling it will be never, but there will be at least one or two resources for whom you have to give certain feedback, which might sound a little bit negative. And a very typical term that is used with such thing is called negative feedback. I mean, we have heard this phrase a gazillion times over like last several years or whatever during our experience in technical field. But one suggestion that came in, and I think even the two managers who were talking about it emphasized it, never call it negative feedback, always call it areas of improvement. That's really a fantastic thought process there. In fact, like a negative feedback is not just limited to giving performance appraisal to folks who are in an IT organization. It applies to say in fields like photography, wherein you are giving, you're criticizing or commenting, and people usually take it like, if this is not right, rather than telling like this is not right, give it like, why don't you do like this, it'll be better. It's a different perspective altogether. Instead of telling you could have composed it, this composition is wrong or this is horrible or whatever, rather say that if you had done like this, it would have looked a little different. So that's like area of improvement. So it's that I liked it, this whole aspect, and that's something which we can adapt to our own day-to-day living as well. So again, it was quite a positive day today. The day ended with my first ever one-on-one for this year with my senior manager, and the conversation started off well about how things are and how this whole vacation went late last month. And he in fact brought it to my notice that there in their country and city, they're back in a lockdown. They're back in a 30-day lockdown, and looks like they're not supposed to go out of the house. But things are all ulta here in our part of the world. In fact, like a festival tomorrow, and there is like a lot of festival preparation going everywhere, including my house. I had stepped out earlier in the evening to pick up sugarcane and banana and all those stuff, and I could see that people are out in the street, though they're making sure that they're wearing masks. There is absolutely nothing that I can complain about social distancing, because there is no social distancing, in fact. But everyone is very enthusiastic and excited about the festival. The first festival of the year, so that's something which I thought I'll bring it up. But again, going back to my senior manager discussion, so we did discuss about how things are changing again and lockdowns and all those stuff. But what really surprised me was the topic that I was talking over the last 2 days about the work assignment and who does what and all those stuff. It seems like his perception about this whole work assignment is different, or maybe that he is not aware of what's happening. I try to bring it to his notice that maybe things are not going right, but for some reason I feel that he has this kind of like a barrier in between the people when he's speaking. Like, he always wants a filtered information, and whenever he thinks that it is not what he expects or not what he wants, he usually retaliates or responds like in a very not really aggressive, but he goes on a very defensive mood. So in that way, that's something which I observed. Maybe I'm wrong, but he tried to give in some input from his side also. But he did tell that things might change in the coming weeks or months, so just be prepared for this and look out for that extra piece of work that is coming into my team. That sounded positive for me. Again, as I told you, the whole day was very positive and very energetic for whatever good reason. So I hope and pray that days are always like this. I mean, it's not an ideal world, but at least this is the type of days that I would expect. So I think that's pretty much it for today. I'll be back tomorrow with an update about how things are related to the festival celebration and all the stuff. It's an off day, so most probably it'll be at home doing the festival, enjoying festival food and things like that. So let me catch up tomorrow and update how things went on the festival day. So until then, take care. Bye-bye.